Well, as a professor of nutrition and food allergy expert for decades and for international as it were, I must ask a very important question, a very sensible question. People say, well, you know, what should we eat? What is healthy eating? What should we eat? And there are really two parts to this. The first part, the first half of the answer, we get from archaeology. If you talk to archaeologists, you know, they know what men traditionally eat before civilization came. They can look at their middens and camp sites and homesteads and so on. And they're pretty clear about that. It's what we call a hunter gatherer diet. And it's, there's a little capsule by the way, which is that most of the calories come from the gathering of women, gathering berries and fruits and things. And the men were sort of big hunter and they cavemen. Actually, we didn't produce that much food. Occasionally, they were making money from the land, and that was it, unless they came from the turkey and the women did the work. But, you know, essentially, it's a diet that would feed you if you were just walking through a forest. So, you could, you know, you'd gather fruit, dig up roots, and berries, and occasionally you'd be looking at some fish and plants and all that. That's man's natural diet, and funny enough, it seems to be the healthy diet, and a lot of people do well in that diet. We use it as the basis of an energy exclusion diet. We put people on a similar diet, and then usually they get well, and then they reintroduce things and see what the problem foods are. And the problem foods are the stress foods, these are allergies, intolerances, and what can we use? But they tend to be standard amongst people, and they are what I call the pharma foods. Now, we've only been pharma for about 10,000 years, so evolutionary came just nothing. You know, it's just a drop in the ocean. But the foods that the pharma would raise, so, you know, crops or grains, for example, dairy produce and cattle, eggs, and then the more modern and peculiar things that the humans are making, like tea and alcohol and sugar, coffee. And then, of course, modern manufactured foods are really drinking. These are not natural foods. These are definitely not quantitative foods. So there's a very broad principle there that should be applied. Okay, but the other half of the story, and for me, this is the most important half of the story, what should we eat? It's important to realize that we're all different. Everybody is sensitive to one or more foods. As I say, often we find a food, but not necessarily. You know, you meet people allergic to fruit, or allergic to fish, or allergic to animals and meats and so on. The point is that you can be allergic to anything, or intolerant. You know, it's not bad down the terminology here, but it doesn't suit them. So each person really has to work out for themselves what's right for them and what's wrong. It's so secret and go and see an allergist doctor, you know, the kind of person I was. They would start with migraine and arthritis and colitis, and they'd give me a workup and they'd see that you're kind of personalized, and they'd say, right, you shouldn't eat meat, don't eat bananas, don't eat potatoes, and so on. But a person can do this for themselves if they have the patience. In fact, I wrote a book about this called Diet Ways. And it's really a self-help manual, you know, how to figure out what foods are good for you and what foods are bad. And the benefits for staying off the bad ones are really enormous. I mean, I think it's quite clear that you live longer, but more importantly, you live better. You know, you feel healthy, energetic, you feel zest and vitality. You look younger, you feel younger. And people will actually say that. You know, you look great, you look 10 years, 15 years younger. What do you want? And you can say, just my own personal health plan. And this is the point, you know, the dogma that surrounds this is all wrong. And you've got vegetarians fighting their plan. Yeah, you've got all these vegetarianism just to fix that. The vegans have another philosophy. There are people, yeah, like the fast beach diet, the Atkins diet, the blood type diet, all of these things, they're all wrong. They will work for some people, but they won't work for everybody. The only diet that works for you is your own personal unique diet. You have to work that out. And that really is the most comprehensive answer that I can give to what's the reality.